If you are uploading stock photos and videos yourself, you may be unaware of a fast and easy method to supply your keywords, title and description to Shutterstock, Adobe Stock, Getty Images, Pond5, and Alamy, among many others. As of now, you are probably doing a lot of copying and pasting. However, there is a better way, and this method involves uploading a CSV spreadsheet file with metadata for each uploaded media file you want to submit for review. Let me walk you through this method with examples and show you how it can speed up your stock photography workflow. There are generally three approaches available to provide your keywords, title, description, and other metadata to stock photography platforms. The first approach is to manually copy and paste titles, description, and keywords for each photo or video and for each stock photo platform like so. This is a highly inefficient and cumbersome method, and you should avoid it as much as possible. The second approach is to embed your metadata directly into your stock photo and video files. When you upload your media files with embedded metadata such as title, description, and keywords, stock photo platforms will get hold of this metadata and you won't have to copy and paste anything. We made a video on how to embed keywords, title, and description into stock photos using Adobe Bridge, linked above and in the description. Using Adobe Bridge is still a somewhat manual method, as it requires you to do a lot of clicking, copying, and pasting. There is a much faster way to embed metadata using a free EXIF tool program that writes metadata automatically into many video and image files at the same time. We made a few tutorials about how to use the free EXIF tool that are linked in the description. This method is our personal choice. However, there is a third approach to supply keywords, title, and description to stock photo agencies, and it is by uploading a comma-separated values or CSV file. Many stock photo platforms, such as Shutterstock, Adobe Stock, Getty Images, Pond5, Alamy, and many others, do accept CSV metadata files for stock videos and stock photos. Let me show you how it looks like. CSV is a spreadsheet format that can be edited by any spreadsheet software, such as Excel. Each stock photography platform requires specific names for each column in a CSV file. Instructions and even the sample CSV file are available. For instance, this is where you can find the upload CSV function on Shutterstock. You can study instructions as well as download a sample CSV metadata file from Shutterstock by clicking on this link. This is how Shutterstock's CSV metadata file looks. There are specific names for each column that Shutterstock requires. The first column must contain your uploaded file's names for which you want to provide metadata. Among things you can supply to Shutterstock are keywords separated by commas, description, categories, and even the column that indicates whether your media is considered editorial or not. Adobe Stock has a similar function accessible through its media upload page. Likewise, there is a sample CSV metadata file with instructions. It looks very similar to Shutterstock CSV file with a few differences. Note that Adobe Stock does not accept descriptions, but rather titles for uploaded images and videos. Getty Images or iStock also provides instructions and a sample CSV file for uploading your metadata on this webpage for deep meta that I will link in the description. Again, the CSV metadata file is very similar to those of other stock photo platforms with a few columns that are specific to Getty, such as brief code, country, and created date. We do not use QHero to submit our content to Getty, and I do not know whether QHero accepts CSV metadata files or not. Pond5 has a similar function of importing metadata from a CSV file that can be accessed through their contributor portal in the upload section down here. Pond5 probably has the most extensive selection of metadata columns that you can provide them with. Here's how Pond5's CSV file looks. It has some very good suggestions in the instructions. Namely, Pond5 advises you to avoid using special characters. I would say that this probably applies to all stock photo platforms. It is less known that Alamy also has an upload CSV metadata function available to contributors. However, you cannot do it yourself. Instead, you have to fill out their template and send it to their image management team over email, who will apply your metadata to the uploaded images. The template looks like this, and it is similar to other agencies with a few Alamy-specific columns. You will need to email their contributor support and ask about the metadata template. Here's a table that summarizes column names for Shutterstock, Adobe Stock, Pond5, Getty Images or iStock, and Alamy. As you can see, the names are very similar across the board with a few differences here and there. When you submit your photos or videos, I would focus your attention on file name, title or description, and keywords columns. Everything else is different and may not be very important. Of course, if it is easy to fill out certain columns, where the value is exactly the same across all files, I would go ahead and fill out that column too. Okay, now let me demonstrate an example of how you would actually use CSV files to upload metadata to stock photo platforms. First, start with a spreadsheet that keeps track of stock photos or videos with the following column names: file name, title, description, and keywords. We personally use Google Sheets to keep track of all our stock content. These four columns are bare minimum, and you can have other columns as you deem necessary. Next, have your file names in the first column. There is an easy trick to get file names in Windows and Mac OS. In Windows, you can go to Explorer, select Files, and hit Copy Path button in Home tab. This will copy not only file names, but also path that you need to remove. To do that, paste path into Excel spreadsheet, hit Ctrl-H to find and replace function, and get the path into find field and have nothing in the replace field, and hit the replace all button. In Mac OS, it's even easier. Select your files in Finder and copy them. Open your text edit app in the application folder. In the format menu, choose Make plain text option. Then, paste your copied media files, and TextEdit will have the names of your files without paths. Next, create title, description, and keywords separated by comma for each stock video or photo as necessary. We made a video tutorial where we shared our top tips and strategies we personally use to efficiently and correctly title and keyword stock photos and videos. I linked this tutorial above and in the description. Because most stock photo platforms have either title or description, we typically have identical values in both fields. However, you can have titles that are different from your media description too, if you'd like. Next is to create separate CSV files for each stock photo agency from this main spreadsheet. If you know a little bit of programming, this is an easy matter to write a Python script that will automatically create these files with different column names for each stock photo platform. Otherwise, you can just do it manually, and it doesn't take very long. What you can do is to have separate files with column names already prepared in advance and with everything else being empty. Then you can just copy-paste data from your main sheet to all CSV files for each stock photo platform like so. Then upload your files. We typically use FileZilla to upload our stock content. FileZilla is a simple file transfer protocol or FTP program that lets you upload your files to many stock photo agencies. The program even lets you save login and password information for each stock photo agency. Next, upload your CSV file. For instance, this is how it works for Adobe Stock. You will get your files updated on Adobe Stock reflecting metadata from the CSV file. And this is how it works on Shutterstock. Here's point 5, and this is how you would do it. And here's how you would do it in Getty Images Deep Meta. With Deep Meta, you would upload your media files together with a CSV metadata file. As you can see, Deep Meta got hold of my metadata successfully. As I mentioned earlier, you would need to email your template to the LME Image Management team. So there you have it. The upload CSV metadata function is a handy and efficient alternative to embedding metadata yourself through Adobe Bridge manually. I would say that this functionality is even on par with using EXIF tool to write keywords, title and description into your media files. We personally use EXIF tool to embed metadata into stock photo images, while we use the upload CSV metadata function for our stock videos, because Shutterstock does not recognize embedded metadata in footage for some reason. This is it for today's tutorial. I hope it helped you discover an efficient method of transferring metadata to your uploaded stock photos and videos, and you won't have to do this work manually again. If you got something out of this video, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel, where we regularly post travel guides and various photography tutorials.